Nikki for Hel Rocks, and I'm here with Paul from Cannibal Corpse. Thanks so much your time.
Thanks for having me.
So I want to go directly on the new album because I heard it. It's wonderful. You never let fans down. But I also noticed that you go a bit outside your comfort zone this time, and maybe it's also because you have an amazing producer and a new one that can bring some new vibe. So can you tell me something about that?
Yeah, well, thank you for the kind words. We think we created a great album for Cannibal Corpse. We do feel it's probably our strongest material to date. I mean, we worked very hard at it. I think the biggest change, like you said, is working with a new producer. I think the sound, yeah, with Mark Lewis this time instead of Eric Rutan, Mark just makes a sound even that much better. I mean, Eric did a great job, but for some reason, the sound on this album as a whole is just phenomenal, and we're really happy for that. And I think the fans are happy. You know, they're saying the same things. So that's awesome. We wanted to have a great sounding record where you can just hear every instrument and they all have a place in the mix and all that. And I think we've achieved that with Mark. But we just really tried to write some same as always, really. Try to write some good Cannibal Corpse songs, some memorable songs, some catchy songs, some brutal songs, of course, evil and dark and all that kind of stuff. That's what we do, Cannibal Corpse. So we're happy, but I think just the diversity in the writing, where, you know, we kind of shift around. It seems, if you notice the credits, Pat wrote actually 5 songs, which is a kind of a first, and Rob having 2.5, and Alex having 4, which usually Alex maybe have a few more than that. But I think it just goes to show that we have great songwriters in the band, and it's not just one person, you know. Mm-hmm. We can all write, and it all be Cannibal Corpse, and it all be good Cannibal Corpse. So, we just felt that we wrote some really good songs. I mean, everyone's gonna have their opinion, like you were saying, about out of our comfort zone, and I wouldn't necessarily look at in the way we wrote the songs or the songs that we're playing are out of our zone too much. I mean, it's Cannibal Corpse.
It's still the same.
Yeah, if anything, it's the production that might be a little bit more different, but, you know, we knew that's out of our hands. We're just gonna we're concentrating on playing the songs, getting tight and performing in the studio, and it's up to Mark to make a sound the way he did, you know.
Yeah.
So I think it's a great record. I think it turned out awesome, and it seems the fans like it as well, so that's a good thing.
Yeah, it's phenomenal. All the instruments are so clear. The bass is wonderful, right. So Alex is going to be super, super happy. It's really strong there.
Yes.
And
yes.
One thing that I know is that this time the rock, you went to record this album in a kind of new style for you guys, a new school, if we go to the previous album. So
right.
Was it weird for you to try this new...
Just different, I guess. You know, we're used to being in an actual studio, you know, be it Morris Sound, Sonic Ranch, or Miami Studios with Eric. Audio Hammer is a different kind of a studio. It's not really a studio. You know, it's like a little, you know, couple of different buildings, basically, where you record the drums isn't where Mark does the guitars or the vocals or anything like that. And so you're recording the drums in a proper drum room, I guess. But it was weird to me because it was a house. It was A.R. Levy's house that's part of the Audio Hammer crew, but I'm set up in his living room, basically looking in the kitchen.
Cool.
It was different, but it really had a great vibe. I enjoyed that. So I'm used to looking at the, you know, the window and the producers looking at you, and that wasn't the case. So it's very different in that way, you know, to kind of, but I loved it. I thought it was a great vibe. You just felt like you were playing in your living room, you know.
Yeah, relax.
And and then when it comes to recording the guitars and all that, yes, there's the guys are in the room with Mark, you know, and they got the sounds and all that, but yeah, it's just not a real studio. It's like a no frills kind of, just, you know, you do what you have to do, and he makes it sound the way he needs to, you know. He does what he does on his end to make it sound the way he does, and you know, those would be questions for him, but yeah, it was a little bit different, and something, like I said, that we've never experienced before. But for my experience doing the drums, I had a great time, and I think the other guys had a great time doing it as well. But yeah, every producer is going to have different techniques and different ways of recording and different methods of going about certain things, and Mark, he had his little bit of differences, but all for the better, really, all for the better, because yes, when you hear the final product, and you know.
Yeah, it's really awesome. Yeah. So, do you change producer more or less every 3 albums? And I bet that one of the reasons is also because you need some new energy and vibe.
Yeah, of course.
Because Cannibal Corpse is dead metal, but then you try also to add
new stuff. I mean, you just don't want to get stale or feel complacent, and just, you know, it's good to just add a little spark or something new right there, you know?
Yeah.
We went, we did three great albums with Eric, and we just felt it was time for a change. And really simple as that, you know?
Yeah.
Just to do something different, exactly, get a new kind of an energy, a new excitement, working with somebody new in a different setting and all. It makes it a little bit that much, I don't know, just like we were saying, just more exciting, I guess, you know, and I like it. I think we all enjoy doing it that way, yes.
And the last time we met, we talked a lot about the lyrics, because you write a lot of lyrics, also for this album.
Right.
And I'm always curious to see, okay, how is going to describe lobotomy this time, you know? So it's really amazing what you did. I really enjoyed the lyrics so much.
Well,
so. I want to know a bit from where you got some inspiration for those new nightmares, where you take us.
Well, for my songs, being that Pat wrote five of the songs on the record, and I've always written every Pat song lyrically, so I wrote his five, and then me and Rob collaborated on the one song, Asphyxiate to Resuscitate, and I wrote the lyrics to that. So I ended up writing six songs, which is half the record. But for me personally, I just really, you know, we come up with titles, we come up with, you know, ideas in that way, and if we got a good title that we're going to roll with, I just delve into my imagination then, really, you know. Some are a little easier, some kind of are more like, okay, I know what I'm going to write about, some may take a little longer, but, you know, it's just delving into the imagination and bringing those stories out from within, you know. I think all the inspiration has been, you know, the outer inspirations like movies and news, you know, that's just been absorbed over the years. I mean, we've been doing this so long, and I mean, but that's my personal way of writing. I don't specifically say, oh, I'm going to start reading some books or watching movies or what have you. It's just, you know, like I said, it stems from, hey, if we got a good title, then I just got to come up with like what that song's going to be about.
Mm-hmm.
Something was a little more vague or just a little more difficult or just kind of like it could have been about anything was the title track, A Skeletal Domain. You know, we when we were writing the music, we thought, well, this is so powerful, this sounds like it could be a title track, and then we adapted the name A Skeletal Domain to that song, and then we said, okay, well, let's call the album Skeletal Domain, and of course now I have to write the lyrics to that, and what I have to come up then in my head, what is this about? It could be about a lot of things, obviously.
Yeah.
Some songs are a little bit more blunt and a little more, okay, you know, well, of course, Asphyxiate to Resuscitate, well, what's that going to be about? Pretty much, you can read the title and understand, maybe, you know, get a gist of what it's going to be about, but A Skeletal Domain could be about a lot of different things, you know? So I had to come up with this story, and that was probably the most elaborate one that I wrote, because being the title track, and I wanted just to kind of, you know, write something that was just a little bit different than I've ever dealt with, and, you know, and then we had to put the album cover to that and everything, but yeah, Skeletal Domain was a good one, because I just wanted to write a story about, you know, about the earth, all the graveyards and the cemeteries basically just kind of like just coming out of the ground all of a sudden, you know, like where it's earth as we know it, but then it's being just totally deteriorated, destroyed by everything coming up from underneath, and everybody dies, you know, but not everybody, you know, it's in the lyrics, some people die, you know, and the way I actually had it was, if you see how I had the meek in there, and to me it was like, the meek shall inherit the earth, but the meek are now left to inherit this earth that's, you know, a skeletal domain, this crazy, flesh, bony, you know, who knows, a very fantasy, kind of futuristic, you know, just a weird world, you know, and then they have to survive, and, you know, if you're talking about the meek are supposed to be, you know, just like probably the humble, you know, people that are going to cause problems and be just, you know, in the earth and be doing their thing, but now, well, that's all that's left, so they have to resort, you know, the higher-ups resort to cannibalism to live, and instead of just being, you know, all right, well, we couldn't do that, well, they did that, and then, you know, then you're starting it over again, because eventually everyone's gonna, you know, if you're gonna eat everybody, well, there's only gonna be a couple people left, or maybe one, you know, and then you're. So I just went off in this weird, twisted kind of thing
there,
you know. You
love this story so much when you tell it.
Well, I have to tell it. I don't tell it very often because it's weird, we don't think of the lyrics that much, you know, being. We concentrate so hard on the music, and that's always been first and foremost. So when we do the lyrics, it's to us, it's necessary, it has to be there. but it really comes down to being secondary for us, you know, because we're lyricists, but you know, we're doing so much work with the music, and that to us that is the key, you know, to be writing, to having the songs. You need the music. So, but I do like that story, how it turned out, and it was probably one of my more in-depth stories that I kind of came up with.
Yeah.
In a while, you know, so.
And this is one of my favorite story-wise.
Well, cool, thanks. Yeah.
The cover, yes. So for Cannibal Corpse, the cover are really important because it's, you know, the best that you put to the album. And this one is a bit dark, mm-hmm. but not as shocking as right. the others. Right. So are you glad that you didn't have to do the flip over cover as in yeah. Torture because you had the double cover? Yeah. This time you're right. good, right?
Right, 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 okay. right. Yeah, well, that's what it was. I mean, it was a mixture of, okay, we just did Torture. You know, we had some other covers that weren't as intense, even going back to The Bleeding. I mean, The Bleeding yeah. is not a very, it really brutal cover. It's weird. It's, you know, a little avant-garde. Or look at Kill. Kill is just Cannibal Corpse with Kill. That's nothing, you know. So we felt, you know, the title, the covers are important, but at the same time, it's not the most important thing, you know. So I think when we did Torture, we had a brutal cover, of course, and we said, you know, and actually talking to the record label too, I think Brian Slagle was, hey, maybe if we could just come up with something that we don't have to worry about censorship and having yeah. double covers and everything, and
yeah.
you know, so we were like, you know, I think it's time to have some more of an epic cover like that,
yeah.
and that's why when we decided on a Skeletal Domain, it's like right there, the title dictates that it's not going to be a Torture album cover. I mean, I don't know, we just wanted exactly what we got. That's what we wanted. We wanted something more dark, more mysterious, more of a landscapey thing that's going to explain or just kind of show a skeleton, what we're talking about, a Skeletal Domain. So I think Vince did a great job. We're very
yeah.
happy with the album
it's
cover.
It's really like the cave.
Exactly.
When you see
right,
it,
right,
it's really
right.
impressive, it's more than maybe Torture.
Sure, sure, because Torture is what it is. It's a
yeah,
shocking
that's
look. That's what
yeah.
you got. You got people hanging there, you know, okay. This is a little bit more in depth than that, you know, like you're saying, just it's mysterious, it's dark. I mean, it makes you maybe a little, it makes you think or wonder a little bit more, you
yeah.
know, like what the heck is going on here? What is this? You know,
yeah.
it's not so easy to figure out, you know, like, you know, an album like say Torture. So yeah, we decided to just do something different in that way, but I think it turned out great. Really,
yeah, yeah.
really love the darkness of it. You know?
Yeah. And lately you are thinking about your career a lot, because with Torture you had some cool gadget for the fan, and now you have a biography.
Yeah, yeah.
Was it weird for you to start working on my biography?
Not too much ourselves, because it was all really Joel MacIver, the author's, it was really his idea. He came to us a few years ago and said, hey, I'd really love to, you know, write a book about you guys, you know, and then we thought, you know, it's, you know, by the time it comes out, it'll be, you know, 25 years, and, you know, we have a story to tell, and, you know, and then we talked to Metal Blade, and they thought it was a good idea, and then, you know, we opted to kind of make it a, you know, kind of a release with the album, you know, get the package deal, a bundle, and have you, what have you, so, and then something different, you know, we don't have that, you know. So for us, it wasn't that hard when you read it, I mean, because obviously we all have our own little kind of few pages of talking mm-hmm. about it. So I was just doing interviews and him asking us the questions. I was talking about the early days and stories like that, and then him compiling the book, really. So for him, you know, it may be a little bit more tedious or, you know, whatever. He's doing most of the work, you know.
Yeah.
We're just talking about stuff like this, and then it's being written down into book form, you know.
And it's a wonderful book of 150 pages of pictures.
I think that's the most
wow.
thing, I think, really, because
yeah.
it's not a tell-all book. It's not like the Centuries of Torment DVD where we're talking about everything, and we got all the ex-members and stuff. This is obviously was concentrating on the five members mm-hmm. that we have, which has been the solid Cannibal Corpse lineup really for a long time. So I think Joel wanted to go that route, and we felt, okay, that's good. Let's keep this focus on the five of us, and that's why there's no, you know, ex-members talking really at all. But you know, having a bunch of cool pictures, that was pretty cool, you know, because a lot of them, most of them, the fans have never seen before. Mm-hmm. So I think that kind of is more of the, you know, the really cool thing about the book. You know, but, I don't know, something about having it though, you know, something in print that you can always just go and always go to pick up, as opposed to putting in a DVD and stuff, you know, put it on your shelf, you can always look at pictures and read things. I like that, and I think
yeah,
a lot of
it looks really
yeah
amazing.
I think a lot of fans would like that as well, so yeah, it was cool, something different, and I hope everybody enjoyed it.
Yeah, and that's last question. If I remember, you got a daughter, right?
Yes.
And you told me the last time that she was singing here and there. How is she going?
Like, yeah, she's doing all right. She's still singing. She loves music. She loves to sing.
Did she listen to the Skeletal
Domain? No, she don't like this. She just has nothing, wants nothing to do with this kind of music. And I'm glad. She doesn't need to.
But not Bieber, please. Not Justin
I don't know.
Bieber.
Well, she likes what she knew. I think my wife just told me she was talking about, what's the band, One Direction?
Oh, my God.
So I think she wants...
We have to say that.
So I know. My wife, to me, that's what little boys and girls like. Yeah. I mean, I remember back until I became about 10 years old when you actually have your own like, you know, and not what's just on the radio and stuff. My wife likes that kind of music too, and my daughter wants to hear those kind of, I have no problem with any of that.
Okay.
But we'll see what she becomes. Who knows? Maybe she'll like, you know, heavier music. Maybe she won't. I really don't care, actually. You know, to me, it doesn't matter, you know. I mean, I'm not concerned about, as long as she's happy, that's really all that matters, you know. Because I'm sure my parents would have said the same thing. As long as I'm happy and I'm listening to music back then that they were like, what the heck is that? You know, what am I, and, you know, I'm sure they were just happy that I'm happy. So I'm just, whatever, if she's happy, I'm happy. So that's all that matters. But yeah, we'll see what happens. I mean, she'll be 9 coming up. So like I said, maybe in a year or so, she'll be starting to actually, you know, wow, I really like that. And it's catching it. Why, you know, because she'll be at that age, you know, to decide for herself and not just, like I said, listening to, you know, the songs that are on the radio and all that kind of stuff. But,
well, thanks for sharing also this private side of you. Thanks so much.
No problem. Thank you.
Yeah, this is Paul for Cannibal Corpse, and check out them new album.
Yes. Skeletal Domain.
Yes. Bye-bye.